break with yours truly. I'm the one and only. I go by the name of Mr. Telefarrell. I want to start here real quick. First off, follow your boy on Instagram, @MrTelefarrell. The goal is 10,000 followers by May 1st. We're at 5,400. Let's get to that goal. Let's knock it on out. Please follow your boy on Instagram, @MrTelefarrell. Now, I want to start here with Chief Keef because I do got a brief update on Chief Keef. I can tell you Chief Keef was placed in handcuffs by a U.S. Customs and Border Protection officer, and this is in Mexico. He was taken into custody. Not a lot of details about what the hell happened to Chief Keef, but I know right now Chief Keef is in custody, and as of right now, there's not a lot of details of what the hell happened, what he could have did, or what he's accused of doing. But yeah, we'll send some love out to Chief Keef. Wish him nothing but the best. And when I get an update, I obviously will let you guys know more about Chief Keef. I wanted to use this video to focus on an artist from my hometown of Memphis, Tennessee. Now, I like to tell people the truth. I don't live in Memphis. I have not lived in Memphis for a few years now. You know, my whole life is in Memphis, but I don't live in Memphis. So I have not run into this artist personally. The reason why I bring that up is I'm an energy guy and I like gauging people's energy. So I couldn't tell you about an LE Choppa. I've been around pretty much every artist to come out of Memphis outside of Juicy J and some of the younger artists, right? But all the big time artists, I've been around them, talked to them, interviewed them. So I don't know about NLE Choppa's energy, but I want to send him some love after he tweeted out some very, very, very scary stuff just hours ago on his social media account. He said, "My music gonna live for me. I'm gonna be with y'all, I promise. My music gonna let you know everything you need to know. I love y'all. Cause I'm gonna kill myself the last day of December 2020. Y'all better enjoy me while y'all can." First off, you don't play about stuff like that. All right, that's serious shit. So I read you two tweets from NLE Choppa's timeline. Let me read you the tweet before he sent out those two tweets, right? Just to use it for context here. He said, "I got three songs in my life with over 100 million views on YouTube. When my next song drop, get ready because that bitch doing 200 million views. Watch," right? I only brought that tweet up to say, yo, NLE Choppa, if you don't have any other reason to live out there, my brother, that's it. You potentially reached 100 million views three times with your music. That's it. You have a powerful fan base. And when you become a music artist and successful, I look at it as your obligation. If you got something to say to your fan base, say it. If you don't, don't. But you saying you don't want to be here, I don't know if you're playing or not. I've heard rumors of drug usage. If he wants us to take his music as face value, he's talked about drugs in his music as well. I don't know if homie owns some, whatever. I hope bruh gets the help that he needs if he's talking about killing himself. You got entirely too much to live for. And if you don't give yourself any credit for anything inside of your music, at least give yourself credit for the fan base you built. Let me tell y'all, y'all know I cover music every day of my life. NLE Choppa has one of the most impressive fan bases I've seen in quite some time. He went and did what iHeart Memphis, out of Memphis, was trying to do with his base, right? He took that social media base and converted it with the streets, got the kids. NLE Choppa has done something that's very hard to do. I tell people all the time, to me, the rapper with the best fan base in music, not naming Drake, Kendrick, or Cole right now, is in an NBA Youngboy. NLE Choppa doesn't have the amount of people that NBA Youngboy has, but he has tapped into NBA Youngboy's fan base, and he has a similar base, which is very tough to do. It's a great fan base to have. You got all different types of demographics, a lot of kids. Yo, there's reason to live just off that kid base that you have, and you from Memphis, you hold it down for the city. He's technically the most socially relevant artist out of Memphis right now. Yeah, he does the numbers better than anyone right now. I'm talking any artist you can name of, from the top on down, Gotti, Dolph, Moneybagg, Youngsta, combine the views that they do, they don't do the numbers that NLE Choppa can do in a week's time span. The facts are the facts. You got too much to live for. Please, somebody get this young man the help that he deserves, because he's clearly screaming, I need help. Right, I'm thinking about killing myself. I'm giving y'all a time and date when I'm going to kill myself. That's not normal. That's not good. I'm wishing him nothing but the best. Here's a quick news break from yours truly. Let's show NLE Choppa some love. If you're a fan of Choppa, in my comment box below, tell me your favorite NLE Choppa record. Let me know what you're rocking out Mine is the Chop, I believe it's called the Chop Block record with Block Boy JB. I think NLE Chopper snapped on that bad boy. I mean, he went in on that one. That's my favorite record from him. And then I like the one of the Shotta Flows, one of the 8 Shotta Flows that he's got out. I'm out. I came from nothing, but I want everything God has for me. I interview celebrities. I talk sports. I still represent the culture.
I got the kids. They tuned in.
We locked in right now,
Mr. Taliaferro.
Mr. Taliaferro.
Taliaferro.
Shout out to Mr. Taliaferro.
You're watching Mr. Taliaferro TV.
Mr. Taliaferro TV.